Assalamu alaikum viewers, please like, share and subscribe this channel. Links of PDF files used in this video are given in description. So today's lecture is about labile and inert complexes, and this is the part 2 of this lecture. So in the previous lecture we have discussed about the lability and inertness of the complexes, and we have classified the complexes on the basis of the presence of electrons in EG and T2G set of orbitals. Now the second classification scheme is based on the crystal field stabilization energy, and we have calculated crystal field stabilization energy of complexes according to crystal field theory. So if the crystal field stabilization energy of a compound is much larger than that of the activated complex or the intermediate, then the compound will react slowly. If the difference is small, then the reaction will be rapid. So the difference between the crystal field stabilization energy of a compound and that of an activated complex derived from the compound affects the rate of the reaction, because the change in CFSE is added to the activation energy of the process. So we will discuss this text in the form of a diagram, then we will have a more clear idea what we are talking about. Consider this example. In this is the octahedral geometry of the coordination complex. So how it will react? That one of the ligand will disintegrate and it will be converted into a square pyramidal form. Now this square pyramidal form which is formed is also called as activated complex, or it is also called as intermediate. Now question is this: why it is converted into a 5 coordinated system? If the ligand replacement has to be taken, then it can be that another X can be attached to this coordination sphere. So actually, as the metal is surrounded by all sides with the help of ligands, so there is no space for entry of the incoming ligand to form the 7 coordinated complex. So it is more appropriate for the 6 coordinated systems, that one of the ligand X will be detached from the overall complex body. So it will be converted into the activated complex or the intermediate. Now if CFSE or crystal field stabilization energy of original complex is greater as compared to the activated complex or intermediate, then complex will react slowly. Or if CFSE of the intermediate or the activated complex is greater, then the coordination complex will react faster. Now if we see this table, the crystal field stabilization energy of octahedral and square pyramidal intermediate or the activated complex, both are zero, so there is no crystal field stabilization energy change. For D1 and D6 system, since crystal field stabilization energy of octahedral is less as compared to the square pyramidal geometry, so this complex will be labile. In case of D2 and D7 system, the crystal field stabilization energy of again the intermediate is greater, so this complex will also be a labile. However, in case of D3 and D8 system, the crystal field stabilization energy of original octahedral geometry or the complex is greater as compared to the intermediate, so this complex, D3 system and D8 system, both will be inert. Similarly, for D4 and D9, again the crystal field stabilization energy of octahedral geometry is less as compared to the square pyramidal form, so this complex will be labile. So what it means that when there is a positive change in crystal field stabilization energy, then those complexes will be inert, and in which there is negative change in crystal field stabilization energy, so those complexes will be labile. Here we see that the crystal field stabilization energy of D0 system and D5 and D10 system, there is no change. So what it means, these complexes are already so much stable that they are not involved in any sort of chemical bonding. So we have that is why we have considered that D0 system is a stable, D5 system is a stable, and D10 system is a stable, because empty orbital is stable, completely filled orbital is already stable, and D5 or half filled orbital is stable. So as a result of its stability, these reactions will not occur or those examples in which these electronic configurations are found, those complexes, they don't react at all. Now the question is, why we have made equivalent D1 to D6, D2 to D7, D3 equal to D8, and D4 equal to D9, and D5 equal to D10. So let's see the electronic configuration arrangements in d orbital. So this is the D1 system, this is D2 system, this is D3, D4 and D5. Now once D5 system is achieved, so it is equal to D0 system, or it is equal to D10 system. The reason is that all electrons are in equal proportion in all orbitals. So D5 and D10 both are equal to each other. Similarly, D0, there is no electron in any orbital, so it means that the charge distribution is nil in all orbitals. Here the charge distribution is parallel, symmetrical, and here the charge distribution is symmetrical. Now after the filling of D5 orbital, when we place D6 orbital, then it is equal to D1 system. As if we see here, to the all the four orbitals, they are empty, but only one orbital contains single electron. Similarly, in D6, all the four orbitals contain single electron, whereas only one orbital contains the double electrons. So as compared to the quantity of the charge, D6 and D1 is equal to one another after filling of the complete D5 orbital. So D2 system is equal to D7, D3 system is equal to D8, D4 system is equal to D9, and D5 system is equal to D10. And this is all on the basis of the charge distribution in the orbitals. So after filling of D5 orbital, D6 we have made is equal to D1, because the overall charge distribution of electrons inside the orbitals quantitatively is equivalent to each. In case of octahedral geometry, we can predict the rate behavior by considering the charge and the size on the center metal atoms. For example, if we consider these complexes, so here the overall charge on the complex is -3. There are 6 fluorides, so -3, so aluminium will have a +3 charge. In this complex, silicon will have a +4 charge, phosphorus will have a +5 charge, and in sulfur hexafluoride, sulfur will having a +6 charge. So as we have seen the mechanism of octahedral geometry, so the mechanism involves bond breaking. So octahedral complex will disintegrate, and one of the ligand will be replaced, and 5 coordinated activated complex or intermediate is formed. So bond breaking is involved. So all those factors which will favor the bond breaking, they will increase the lability of the complex. So that is why, as aluminium has +3 charge, whereas silicon has +4 charge, phosphorus has +5 charge, whereas sulfur has +6 charge. So because aluminium has less positive charge, so it is easy to break the bond of fluoride. So that is why the lability order of aluminium complex is very much higher as compared to silicon, which has higher, as compared to phosphorus complex, which has then higher rate as compared to the sulfur complex. Similarly, in case of water exchange, if we see here the lability order, so sodium has the greatest lability order as compared to magnesium, which has greater lability order as compared to aluminium. The reason again here is sodium has +1 charge, whereas magnesium has +2 and aluminium has +3. So it is more easy to break the ligand in sodium positive complex as compared to aluminium. So that is why the lability of sodium complex is greater as compared to magnesium, which has greater lability order as compared to aluminium. The second factor which we can relate is the size of the center metal atom or ion. If there is greater size, then the overall charge per unit area will be reduced. So it is easy for a greater size metal to break the bond of one of the ligand as compared to the smaller size metal. So that is why strontium having a greater size, the lability order in strontium complex is greater as compared to calcium, and which has a greater lability order as compared to the magnesium. So in case of magnesium, the size is too much small, it has plus 2 charge. So this plus 2 charge is covered in very small area, so per unit area the charge is greater, so it will attract the ligand, so it will be difficult to break the bond. So that is why in case of magnesium the rate is slowest as compared to calcium and strontium. So on this basis we can predict the rate. The rate of the complex also depends upon the geometry of the complex. It has been notably observed that 4 coordinated coordination complexes react more fastly as compared to the 6 coordinated complexes. The reason is that there is enough room around the center metal for 5th group to enter the coordination sphere, and the presence of an additional group would aid in the replacement of the original ligand. So 4 coordinated complex mein itni space hoti hai ki 5th jo ligand hai that can be enter in the complex, whereas 6 coordinated system mein ye possible jo hai wo nahi hai, because there is not enough space. Or second, the reason is that ke bond breaking is involved in 6 coordinated complexes and bond making is involved in 4 coordinated complexes. And when we talk about 4 coordinated complexes, then we are talking about both tetrahedral and square planar geometries. So if we see here, in case of nickel, palladium and platinum, there will be a greater lability of the complexes involving nickel. The reason is that because in 4 coordinated systems, rather than to make an intermediate of 3 coordinated complexes, we make the intermediate of again 5 coordinated complex. So what it will cause, that in the rate determining step bond making is involved, and all those factors which will favor the bond making will make the complex to react fastly. So as in case of nickel, palladium and platinum, since the size of nickel is small, so nickel is having a greater charge density, so it will welcome an incoming ligand to form a 5 coordinated complex. So that is why the reactions of nickel are fast as compared to the complex involving palladium and as compared to the platinum. Similarly, if we compare the rate of gold tetrachloride complex and platinum tetrachloride complex, so in this complex the gold has plus 3 charge, whereas platinum has plus 2 charge in this complex. So since gold has plus 3 charge, so it will attract more effectively the incoming ligand. So that is why the rate of this reaction is fast, and it is approximately 10^4 times faster as compared to the platinum. So from this discussion we conclude that the rate of a reaction depends upon the mechanism, and this involves in the configuration and energy of the activated complex and hence the activation energy. For octahedral system, the activation energy is strongly influenced by the breaking of metal ligand bond, whereas in case of 4 coordinated system, the formation of new metal ligand bond is involved, and it is favored by the large positive size of the metal. So we conclude that the factors which decide the rate of the 6 coordinated system are not applying to the complexes which are smaller in coordination number. So the rate behavior is depend on the mechanism of the reaction, and which can be perceived by various parts. So in this lecture we have concluded that crystal field stabilization energy, the size of the metal, the charge on the metal, the charge density of the complex, these are the factors which also help us to predict whether the particular complex will be labile or not. So this was all about for today's lecture. I hope you all have understood this well. If you have any confusion, let me know in the comment section. I will reply as at my earliest. Okay, thank you. Allah Hafiz.